Hey everybody, it's 40 Warrior. Welcome back to Spyro 3, You're the Dragon. Last time we liberated Sergeant Byrd's base and learned how to use Sergeant Byrd. Just basically long distance warfare the whole time. And we're back here in the Sunrise Spring, and Zoe's standing right here.
Spyro, I found an egg, but only Sparx will be able to reach it. There's a small hole that leads to a crawdad farm. I can take him there if he's ready.
Yeah. New to this game, Sparx gets his own bonus worlds. You can't die in these. And there's one in every world. It's 200 gems and an egg. Every single one, I think. If memory serves me right.
Hello, Sparx. Maybe before you take on the nasty crawdads, I should give you some help. To start, let's practice shooting. Press the circle button to shoot these targets.
Yeah, because apparently Sparx has this ability to shoot things. It has a limited range, though. So just bear that in mind. And also, you get to hear the title theme through all of Sparx's worlds. So get used to that! But this is his primary line of attack, right here. It's kind of reliable, actually.
You can also move quickly by charging, like Spyro. To charge, hold down the square button. Use your charge to chase down this fast enemy.
Introducing one of the biggest lies in this whole game, the charge. The charge? Oh, it looks great. I mean, I'm charging this guy, blah, blah, blah. And you do go around faster. That's not the lie. That is the lie right there. Hitting enemies. 99% of the enemies you charge into will hurt you. I'm dead serious. Yeah, charging hurts you. If you hit an enemy.
Now for the hard part. Being a maneuverable dragonfly, you can also slide in any direction. To slide, hold down the L1 or R1 button. Then move with the analog stick or directional button. Try sliding up and...
This is one of the best features that Sparx has, though. This is strafing. Essentially, slide, strafe. Yeah, you're gonna be using this a bunch. Especially if you get pinned down in an area and you wanna strafe. It'll be extremely reliable. Trust me on that. And also now the final part of this.
On your travels, you'll notice butterflies that give you health, just like in the dragon worlds. Not only that, but some butterflies will give you special powers, though only for a short time.
The special power ones,
just
though,
eat any
do not give you health.
And then press the X button to use that power up. Your power up is shown.
So there's a ton of power-ups, believe it or not. This one right here is probably the most common. This right here is the rapid fire. You hold down, it does that. It's very, very, very good. But its effectiveness is kind of limited to holding down the button, as if you just tap like that, it's not very reliable. And, well, my retardation.
You'll be able to deal with
my retardation just got the best of me there. LP curse, yeah! Alright, anyway, now how a real pro does this. I guess I'll reload, whatever. Yeah, it's actually a really good power-up right there. There's some even better ones, though.
Looks like you're ready, Sparx. If you need any more help, just choose the help option from the pause menu.
So anyway, here we are, Sparx Worlds. These are relatively easy, but because you get infinite tries, it kind of takes away from the difficulty of the game. Like I said, you lose Sparx, you don't lose life, which kind of makes sense because in the world of Spyro the Dragon, you could lose Sparx and just have him magically revived by a butterfly. And they're giving me a purple gem already? What? Okay, thank you. So anyway, I mentioned charging is a huge lie. Yeah, I'm charging into these enemies and I'm taking damage. That is so stupid. Why would you introduce that as an attack if it's not an attack? And now they gave us the rapid fire. And you see right there is a box. That's kind of why the slide is the most reliable move in the game, or in the Sparx worlds, because as long as those boxes or whatever stay intact, infinite enemies will pour out. That's why you notice enemies don't give you any gems, but blowing up things like that does. And we have a different color of butterfly. What could this be? Let's check it out. Rockets. Three rockets, and... well, yeah, they home in. It's nice. We also got a red key, you noticed. So we need to find a red door! And oh my god. Enemies everywhere! Enemies everywhere! Ah! As you notice, they all like to funnel in. So no matter how many crawdads or whatever enemies you face, they'll always try to funnel in and get right into your line of sight, which makes it kind of easy. And that's what also makes the slide such an easy function to use. It's such a reliable function. It's almost like getting them into your line of fire. Now the rockets aren't that reliable because, well, they only take out 3 enemies a pop, so you can take out a maximum of 27 enemies per butterfly. Now you notice there is this little problem here. That is an impenetrable shield. So we need to find the switch that turns it off. And right there we have a new type of enemy. Which absolutely does jack shit. Just charges at you for no reason. Oh, jeez. Let's get this. What is it? Invincibility! Sweet! Now charging is actually very useful. Because, well, you don't take damage ever. And here's a switch. And that's what happens when you use up the switch. Pretty awesome, huh? Like I said, these are very simplistic levels. Very simplistic. Relatively easy and very simplistic. In my opinion, these aren't too bad. Oh, the flame. Nice. I like this one. So while it does the same thing as the rockets, it actually can pour through multiple enemies like that. It burns enemies quite reliably. And it seems to bounce off enemies and just take out everything in its wake. Really awesome. I would recommend you always check the corners because typically they will hide gems there, but gems will be lying there more often than not. So always bear that in mind as you're doing this. And just remember how good that flame is. Oh man. This one is ridiculously easy. They'll get a little harder later on, particularly the last one I remember being pretty difficult. And once again, showing how the slide is so helpful. And through here should be our first boss. There's a boss in every single Sparx world. And typically it'll be in a wide open area like so. And typically the bosses are quite easy. And they do have multiple phases. This guy, for example, has lost his claws already. And now I'm just dismembering him some more. Whoa, Nelly. Where'd you get that? So anyway, there you go. That's the Sparx world, ladies and gentlemen. And if all went according to plan, 200. 201 egg. We're done here. So, yeah, that's the Sparx world, everybody. Very, very easy and simple. And, yeah, everything I said 5 times throughout.
Nice work, Sparx. You've beaten the Crawdad King and found the lost egg. Not only that, but some of the dragon magic seems to have rubbed off on you. Now you can pick up gems when they're even further away from Spyro.
Okay, that is really, really awesome. Not. Now you think about it, I mean, you can notice it if it's there. If you really focus on a gem, you will notice that Sparx does reach a little further, but what's the point? I mean, you're going for a gem, right? You're going to go directly to the gem. You're not going to, you know, run away from the gem and have Sparx just sort of slide out of nowhere and snag it. So it's a really useless power. Anyway, back here, I'm going to meet you at Sergeant Byrd's lair, or the one area where you can use Sergeant Byrd. Thankfully, the shortcut makes it a lot easier. Here we are, Sergeant Byrd. What's up?
Hello, Spyro. I'm just off to the Tiki Lodge for some R&R.
I do like the voice, though, for Sergeant Byrd. And where's his body? What's the flippin' hell? What did you do? You are a murderer, you bastard!
I'm playing a game of hide and seek with my friends. If I can't find where they've hidden their heads, they won't let me join the Tiki Lodge. Help me put them back together, and I'll make you an honorary member.
Hide and seek by dismembering their heads? What type of matter of bullshit is this? Anyway, don't worry if you shoot one in the lava, it'll automatically respawn. Or should. See? Because apparently these clay people are actually very, very magical people. Or something like that, I have no idea. So anyway, that's done. These toucans here will not hurt you, but they will interrupt your flight if you bump into them. Which is why they tend to fly around everywhere in this area, and they also respawn. They don't give you any gems either, if you're wondering. So these guys are just here to simply annoy you. Pretty simple concept. Oh, where are you going? So anyway, it's just a matter of flying around the area trying to find these playheads, like so. So you notice right there, Sparx did pick it up a little farther along, but like I said before, I was going to pick it up either way. So the point of that whole exercise being what? Sergeant Byrd, you're kind of uncontrollable at this point. It don't matter, the heads always right themselves, so it's kind of like The Exorcist. And this is a cracked wall, so let's hit an egg. That's why you gotta be looking out for cracked walls. And yes, there is one more egg, obviously, when you are finished with the game of hide and dismemberment. Whoa. I stuffed that one. I mean, I don't know what else there really is to say other than the fact they just burned my feathers again. Well, bird's feathers, I should say. I don't have feathers, I'm a human being, after all. And I probably just made someone PETA very angry for my treatment of the birds. And no, I'm not going to make anything about how this part is definitely going to the birds, because it hasn't gone to the birds yet. Although human hide and dismemberment is not exactly a type of game you would want anybody to be playing. A sane human being, for that matter. Because we have a term for that. It's called mass murderer. Yeah, I know, that totally wasn't cool at all, but it's true. Them's the facts. Are you going to deny that? I'm unbiased. Okay, I'm missing one. Up here? Up here. I really don't like how the music just suddenly goes silent for such an extended period of time. Nice! Tells me I wasn't missing a gem earlier, so that's awesome. Let's get the hell out of here. See, that's what the toucans will do. They'll just simply interrupt you.
As a sign of your honorary membership in the lodge.
Yay! An egg! An egg. Another Ryan.
Well, that's never happened before. I hope it's not a bad omen.
Do you, examine your eggs? Because maybe you would notice that that is a freaking dragon egg and not an average Tiki Lodge egg, which I'm guessing you probably eat. Why would stone people eat them, though, is beyond me. I'm not sure. Shall we go into the detail of what clay people eat? Or shall we just simply stay away from that topic? I choose to stay away from the topic. So, anyway. Yeah, now we're legitimately 100%, without equivocation, done here. See? 100%. Woohoo! We did it. So next time, we're definitely going to be in the Midday Gardens world, and we're going to be doing stuff there. And you notice a lot of them tend to have 500 gems now. Yep. That part has also gone up. So taking care of one of the areas now is not a smart move because of how late, how long this has been going, at 15 minutes. So, yeah, now's a good time to actually stop in. Next time I'll meet you at Icy Peak. Oh, if you're wondering what they're building.
I've assessed the situation. We need 5 men to operate the whirligig.
Whirligig? Pardon me while I go bang my head against the wall now. See you guys on 40 Warriors signing off. At the next part, not be banging my head against the wall.